So we recently hit 1,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel. And once again, I want to say thank you for your support. And earlier this week, I asked you on YouTube and Instagram to ask me anything you want so that you can get to know me better. So I'm here today to answer those questions. So let's get right into it. I'm going to start with YouTube questions and just go from the top down. All right, so the first question is life lessons to give your younger self. It can be about relationships, mentality, work ethic, etc. Now that's a great first question. One lesson I would give my younger self is to learn to be disciplined. I think being disciplined is the key to achieving anything you want, because something like motivation is only there to hype you up in the moment, right? But discipline is there to push you through, you know, rain or shine, because every day that goes by, that's a day you'll never, ever, ever get back. Just really think about that. So if you got shit to handle, discipline is what will make those days count. So if you want to lose weight, being disciplined in your diet and exercise will get you there. If you want to do well in school, you know, being disciplined in your studies and homework will get you there. If you want to learn an instrument, you know, being disciplined in your practice will get you there. So if your life is a movie, this puts you in the director's seat, right? So however you want this movie to play out, it will, as long as you're disciplined. So how do we get more discipline? I would say you need to start by having a plan and a schedule for your goals. So I have a list of things you need to be doing and knock them out every day, because if you're just doing random shit at random times, that's going to lead to random results. And surround yourself with like-minded individuals, right? People with similar goals and aspirations. And focus on the little goals, not the big goal. Because the big goal, that's the reward, right? The little goals is what's gonna get you there. So don't get too worked up on the big goal and just focus on what's in front of you. Next question. How long did it take you to become profitable? Okay, so I got a few of these questions and I get this asked all the time. So the first 4 months of my trading were all losing months, but ever since then, I've never had a losing month after that. So that's pretty unheard of in this business. You know, usually hear people say it took years, not months. But my case was pretty unique. I had and have a great mentor who's taught me everything he knows. And I'll tell you the full story in a later video. Now, that doesn't mean it was raining money after those 4 months. It just means I started going positive, right? So to answer your question, it took me about 4 or 5 months to start going positive. Next question. This person has three questions. And the first one is, what other long-term forms of investing do you believe are best? So other long-term forms of investing, other than stocks, I'm guessing. Well, one I really believe in is real estate. So with real estate, you know, you can force appreciation. You can have others build equity into your property by renting it out. We actually just closed on another house, and we're gonna turn this house, this current house, into a rental property. So right now I'm trying to build up my real estate portfolio, and it's a great way to beat inflation, right? We can all agree that real estate appreciates in time. If you look at home prices 10, 20, 30 years ago, no matter the crash, in long term, it continues to climb, while the value of the dollar continues to decline. If you have $100,000 10, 20, 30 years ago, it's not the same $100,000 that it's worth today. So the value of homes is rising while the value of the dollar is declining. So if you have money to invest and you don't know where to put it, don't keep it in the bank or under your mattress. Real estate is a great long-term investment that you can look into. Now, you know, every market is different in every city, and every law is different in every state, so you gotta do your due diligence. But if you don't wanna deal with all that, you can also look into private lending. So if you wanna make, you know, 8 to 12% APR on your money, let me know, I'll hook you up. All right, next question. Well, it's a three-part question. So your next question is, would you ever go live on YouTube for a trading session to get a sample of how you trade live? I wouldn't be able to do that because I do trade in a trading room. So I'm there from the pre-market till close. So I'm kind of committed to that. But if you want to see how a sample of how I trade live, you know, if you look at any of my day in the life videos, you can pretty much get a sample of how I trade there, because I'm pretty much recording, you know, me trading live. And then your third question is, we'd love to learn more about your family as well, maybe a future video. Yeah, for sure. I'll try to get the wife and the kid involved more in later videos. All right, so the next question. Okay, so how much did you start with? How much did you need before comfortable with going full time? Okay, so I started with a $30,000 account, but I was only trading with $5,000 of that. The reason I had $30,000 was to bypass the PDT rule, the pattern day trading rule, which limits your day trades for any accounts under $25,000. So I was risking 50 bucks a trade, which is 1% of the 5,000, and then just grew my account from there. And then the second part of your question was, how much did you need before becoming comfortable with going full time? So I pretty much went full time almost right away. So before I got into day trading, I was in the apparel business. Me and my wife have a wholesale business together. Me trading on the West Coast, the market closes at 1 o'clock here. So I still have an extra half day to still help run the apparel business. So I was pretty much trading full time right out of the gate. But to answer your question of when did I feel comfortable, let's say with my day trading income, was that first March of 2020. So that's when the pandemic hit, and that month I ended up making $40,000 in 1 month, just risking 200 bucks a trade. So that's the first time I started learning to scalp and started to make some real money. So it was about 9 months into my career when I felt comfortable with the income. Next question. Can you teach us how to scan stock, what to trade before market open, or what you use to scan stock? It helps us a lot. Okay, so that's like hours of teaching I would need to do. But basically, I like to trade gaps. So in the pre-market, I'm scanning for stocks that are gapping up or down 2% or more. And then I go through the list, each one, analyzing them to see which ones I'm gonna play for the open and which ones I'm gonna play for later. Now, I can't explain my analyzing process in just one answer, but basically what I'm looking for is shock value, location of the gap, size of the gap, long-term pattern, and the relative strength and weakness to the market, okay? And then to answer the last part of your question, what you use to scan stock. So I think it'll be easier to just show you. So I think I'll just make a video out of it on how I scan for gaps in the pre-market and how I scan throughout the day pretty much. I use Thinkorswim, so I'll show you how I built in a free gap scanner into the platform, okay? Next question. How do we join your trading room, and can you show us show us how to make your share sizing for risk on Excel or whatever way you made it. So actually, it's not my trading room. I just help moderate it. So I'm only on there for 2 time slots every day. But if you're interested, shoot me a DM on my IG. And also for the share sizing sheets, I'll try to somehow attach it into the description of the video, but I don't know if that's possible. So if you don't see it there, yeah, just follow me on IG, shoot me a DM, and I'll email it to you, all right? Next question, how you started. Okay, so this is another common one I got. So pretty much, how did I get started? Where did I learn to day trade from? I think also for this one, I'm gonna tell you guys my full story from how I got started to how I accelerated so fast and got to where I am today in a separate video. I think it'll be beneficial to hear the full story in detail. But for as a summary, just to answer some of these questions. So I came across a webinar about day trading, didn't know a thing about it at the time, and ended up signing up for an in-person mentorship program out in Chicago. It was like a week-long crash course event where I got to trade live next to the professional day trader. And he pretty much taught me everything he knows. And then after that event, I pretty much got hooked and followed him in his trading room. And then, you know, started to put out ideas. And he noticed that I had potential. So he pretty much took me under his wing. And then, you know, became my mentor and now a good friend, and just grew from there. So yeah, I'll tell you guys the full detailed story in a later video. But this person is also curious about, are you rich before day trading? Mean, are you well born? Well, anything, right? LOL. So This person wants to know if I grew up with a rich family, if I come from a place of money already. And to answer that question, I would say I grew up comfortable. Both my parents were working parents. We grew up in a 2-bed, 2.5-bath condo. They drove a Mercedes. They didn't really spoil us, but we never had to worry about food, clothes, you know, roof over our head, anything like that. Never had to worry about bills. So comfortable, right? But now I'm at a position where I give them money. So I don't know if that helps answer your question. They're probably watching right now. Thank you guys for your hard work. I love you. Next question. Is it option trades that you do? And if not, what type of trading do you mainly do? And what software do you use to place trades? So I trade stocks itself. I used to trade options, but there's just too many variables with options. You have to worry about the Greeks, right? The Delta, Theta, Gamma, Vega, and how they all affect the premium prices. But with stocks, you just buy at this price, sell at this price. The difference is what you make. So for my style of trading, for how I like to trade, I like to keep it simple, and it's what works for me. So I stick with just stocks itself. As for what software do you use to place trades? I use two. I use Thinkorswim or TD Ameritrade and E-Trade are my two brokerages where I execute my trades, and I use them because they're free commissions. Next question. So how many R's a week on average so far this year? Okay, so we're at the end of March now. So we're pretty much finishing up the first quarter of the year. And I'll admit that this quarter has been one of the slowest quarters I've traded through in my career so far. Now, the entire quarter wasn't slow. I mean, there were some hot spots inside of that, but overall just slow, I would say, especially in the afternoons where it just goes completely dead. But having said that, I was still fortunate enough to make some money. And, you know, I could blurt out any number. Who cares? I think it's better to just show you. So I'll put it up in the screen somewhere, exactly what I'm up. I don't even exactly know what I'm up. But you know, this is just my day trading account. I also do swing trading, some other things, but yeah, whatever it is, that's what I'm up on, okay? Okay, so next up, we have a couple of questions from Instagram. And the first one is, what did your personal finance management look like in high school / college? Okay, so I was a bit of a troublemaker in my teenage years, and all my money went to drugs, alcohol, and partying, right? I've made money through slinging weed. I got kicked out of high school, went into rehab at the age of 16. Lots of fun stories there. But yeah, in terms of personal finance management, it went through my nose and into my mouth. That's what it looked like. But yeah, my parents are still watching. Sorry again for putting you through hell, but hey, I didn't turn out too bad, right? Next question, can we hang out again? Yes, we can, David. So my cousin David took me out to some hot pot last weekend, and I'm not a fan of hot pot. I'm more of a shabu shabu guy, but the place he took me was one of the best, or the only hot pot place that I approve of. I think it was called like Hallelujah or something like that, but it was freaking bomb. And we definitely need to do this again, but this time it's on me. Okay, freaking this guy put his credit card in before we even sat down, so next it has to be on me. All right, so from where should I start to learn to trade, like books, website, courses? Okay, so there's a lot of ways to make money in the stock market. So I think the first question you need to really answer is which trading methodology do you click with, right? What strategies make sense to you? What fits your style of trading? Like for me, I like gaps trading. You know, maybe for you, it could be options trading, futures. Maybe it's focusing on the big names, right? Like Google, Apple, Tesla, Microsoft. So whatever it is, whoever you're learning from or wherever you're learning from, I think the important thing is to always ask why. So, you know, if A happens, why am I doing B? If B happens, why am I doing C? And if those answers, you know, make sense to you and it works for you, then I would, you know, dig deeper into that system, that methodology, and try to utilize everything I can, whether it's from books, courses, the websites, use them all, right? But the important thing is, of course, is to get started, all right? Okay, so the next question is the last question. And the question is, what's the biggest disagreement you have with your wife when it comes to money? What a great question to end the video. So the biggest disagreement, I would say, it would have to be paying for convenience. So for example, you know, if we were to take a trip on a flight, my wife would want to upgrade, you know, to first class. I don't mind sitting coach and saving that some of that money, even though we can afford the first class. You know, why valet when you could self-park, that kind of shit. And I think I recently changed my mind because of Tyson. Tyson is my two-year-old son. So, you know, we recently started to travel with him, taking him out. And, you know, we recently went on a family trip. And I didn't know how Tyson would respond on a public flight. So we tried the private jet thing, which was amazing. You know, when we took him to Disneyland, I didn't want to wait in line, you know, for long periods of time and have him throw tantrums and all that. So we did the whole VIP tour thing where you just skip the line and ride whatever you want and get out of there. And what I found was that I saved so much time. And, you know, when you start using your time to do productive things that, you know, benefit you and your family, you start to look at time differently. I value my time so much now that when I experience, you know, the private jet, the VIP tour, like I was saving so much time that it kind of flipped the switch on me. So now I don't want to save money, I want to save time. You know, my wife always had the mentality of, you know, she approached it as, why save money when we can just make more money, right? So she had that kind of hustle mentality. So now I kind of have that approach as well. So now I hate waiting for shit. Like, I love saving time now. So, you know, I'm down to pay for convenience. So that's gonna do it for this Q&A. Thank you guys so much for the awesome questions and support. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like. And as always, I appreciate you for being here, and I hope to see you on the next one.